Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining variable length subnet masking, or VLSM. I know I say this every time, but it's important. If you like what you see in my videos, please take a moment to subscribe so you can get updates to newly published content. And if you do find this video informative, please do click that thumbs up button. In previous videos, we talked about classful and classless IPv4 addressing. VLSM is a technique that is fundamentally based on classless IPv4 addressing. If you haven't seen those videos yet, please take a look at them before you continue here, because it'll make your understanding much clearer. The links to those videos are in the description below. The VLSM technique, simply put, is the practice of using different subnet mask sizes when you perform subnetting, allowing for more efficient use of IP addresses. This means that each subnet can have a size that is appropriate for its needs, rather than being constrained to the sizes dictated by the classful network architecture. The subnet mask is used to define the range of addresses that exist within a subnet. Here you can see a table of various subnet masks and the sizes of subnets that each can create. By examining how many hosts you expect to have within each network segment, you can choose the appropriate subnet size. Now, to help us understand VLSM more thoroughly, let's take a real-world example. I am the administrator of a municipal network that contains about a dozen buildings that are interconnected by a municipal area fiber optic network. This whole network is connected to the national public sector internet service provider. As a municipality, the ISP has provided a network address space of 10.96.0.0/21. This subnet provides IP addresses ranging from 10.96.0.0 all the way to 10.96.7255, and that gives us a total of 2048 addresses. Now, to more appropriately and efficiently use this address space, we were called upon to subdivide this into subnets for use within the municipality network. These subnets were assigned to particular network segments. Now, network segmentation in an enterprise network can take various forms, but for the municipality, each building is given a segment, as well as the data center and the management VLAN. Based on the number of hosts in each of these segments, the subnet mask length for each subnet must be decided. So let's take a look at some of these network segments to see what subnets were used for each. Now, this is just some of the subnets in the network, and I don't show them in order. I won't go into how subnetting calculations were done. If you want to see those subnetting calculations, check out my subnetting in action videos in the description below. But here we do see the results of subnetting using VLSM. Now, the significant thing here is that you can see that the subnet mask length is variable. It changes for each subnet based on the size that you need. Now, if, for example, we were to keep the same subnet mask length at /24, we would only have 8 subnets, but that's not enough. If we were to use /26, which is a smaller subnet size, then we would have 32 subnets, which may be enough, but each subnet size is much too small for our needs. VLSM allows us to mix and match subnet sizes based on our needs, thus more efficiently using the address space provided. The municipality currently has 33 used subnets, with several that are currently unused and are saved for future use. Now, one last thing I'd like to say that is important when we perform VLSM and when we choose our subnet sizes. We must make sure that we are leaving enough room for future growth. If a particular network segment grows in the number of hosts and you have not taken this into account, you may not have room to accommodate them in your design subnets. For example, here we see that the management VLAN could have used a smaller subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. But that would be much too restrictive because we only have room for two additional hosts. So we made sure that we would use the next largest subnet size, which gives us 126 hosts to accommodate this growth. It's very difficult to readdress your address space once it has been created. At the municipality, we did have some such cases. However, we've had this address scheme for close to 14 years. So we've had relatively few address space changes necessary for that time period. So I think we did a relatively good job. So VLSM then is a technique that uses variable subnet mask sizes to ensure the most efficient use of your address space. It's a direct result of the classless IP addressing approach. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.